I tell you, the Pink Queen Foundation gives you hope, they give you love, they give you encouragement, they are there with you when you're crying, when you're going through pain, they are there. They've helped you out, if they can, financially. Nene tells us all the time, she says, all cancer matters. So every color of the rainbow that people who do have cancer, they help out. And I also donate it back to them. And that's what we need to do, to help out the Pink Queen Foundation so that the Pink Queen Foundation can continue giving out hope for those who are battling cancer.
There is help out there, tremendous, tremendous help, like the Pink Queen Foundation. And Tanisha has a heart of gold. She helped me in my downtime, so I want to pay it forward by being involved myself and being an advocate for myself and others.
It's been such a wonderful journey, meeting women who look just like me, close in age, and just having someone to talk to on a level of understanding. I find myself throwing myself into any kind of cancer assistance because I believe all cancers are important, and just helping people is one of my greatest joys, and I get the most from it. As a survivor of breast cancer, I would like to partner with the Pink Queen Foundation and just getting the word out and letting everyone know no one fights the fight alone. We are all here to help.
I'm forever grateful for the people that have come into my life, so much so. The Pink Queen Foundation has been wonderful to me. She's come over to my house, she's been available over the phone, she brought me a lovely basket when I was first diagnosed. It was just that nice touch. And you know, that's something when you're in the middle of all this and that fear that you have, that's very comforting to have, and knowing that she's always available anytime that I want to just reach out, cry, or just go ahead and talk about the different types of treatments and just have someone to talk to.
About 14 years ago, my mom was diagnosed with a brain tumor that reoccurred in her breast and then again in her leg. I was really kind of broken this holiday season with not knowing what to get her, with the chemo really taking its effect. More than anything, I wanted to uplift my mom's spirit, and I was in desperate need of that. And after speaking with a friend about it, she referred me to the Pink Foundation. I reached out, and I'm so grateful. I was blessed with gift baskets for my mom and myself. The gratitude that I have is indescribable, and this really will uplift my mom's spirit. She's been broken for so long, and I'm happy that she has something that it's unique and catered for her, that she'll be able to smile again, because I know it's really hard and devastating with what she's going through right now. But I'm ever so grateful for the foundation, what they've done for my family this holiday season.
The Pink Queen Foundation, it was started out of my journey. I was diagnosed with breast cancer at the age of 37. Back in 2011, and I had a good support system, but people that would contact me that were about to embark the journey, they were struggling. So I found myself getting through my journey as well as helping them get through their journey. And I would assemble baskets, like wellness baskets, to give them for comfort. And those baskets is turned into the foundation. Although our gift of giving is centered around a basket, we do assist with medical copays. We assist with gas vouchers, you know, groceries, cell phone, utility bills. You know, if our funding is there, we have it to support. We were established in 2016. When I say established, I mean registered through the state of Florida, but we've actually been serving people since 2013. It's been beyond my expectation. It was something that I believe God wanted me to go through so that I can have a ministry to reach out and help others. We've probably helped about 75 families. And that includes men, women, children, and people of all backgrounds, races, religions, ages. So many people are being diagnosed daily of, you know, different types of cancers, rare cancers. It's something that we really need to educate ourselves on. You have people that they may have been diagnosed with breast cancer, but then if they get a reoccurrence, you know, it could metastasize to the brain or the bone, ovarian. Our organization connecting with all types of cancers, it allows us to be more resourceful and knowledgeable to assist those that are newly diagnosed and also be able to answer questions. It's nothing like experience, being able to refer someone or give them information based on knowledge and experience. People think, oh, you have surgery, you do the chemotherapy, but it can go on for years. It could be very overwhelming. It just depends upon the mindset of the person. I've learned just by working with others that everyone's journey is different. I try to tell people, respect people that have been diagnosed and don't just categorize them as, oh, you have cancer, you'll be fine. Yes, they'll be fine, but you don't know what a person goes through if you haven't been through it. I would tell a family member if they are dealing with the issue to just try to maybe be a support. And when I say be a support, maybe help prepare dinner, offer to clean, offer if they have kids, offer to, you know, take the kids to and from school or their extracurricular activities. You know, maybe offer to pay a bill or anything that will help make life easier for the person that's battling is really the best approach to provide support. We have made a presence in the community, in several communities. We've spoken at several religious organizations such as churches, clubs, private organizations, community events. We have really been out there spreading our wings. It's like God is just sending the assignments and we're able to go to the workshops or the health fairs or the ladies events at churches and share the journey of the foundation. It's beyond amazing. When we founded the name, it was more personable and it represents me and my journey. There are many pink queens out there. You know, not everyone that's a queen is pink, but you know, that's what makes our pink unique. My pink is unique is our tagline. So, and that opens it up for us to show variety. Our organization, we don't fund medical research. What we do is we make a personal connection with cancer survivors. So when you're making a personal connection with cancer survivors, you're going to be coming in contact with cancer survivors of different types of cancers. And those cancers are not pink. So that's what makes us unique. Our mission is to inspire people, encourage them, let them know they're not alone. Also encouraging the caregivers, you know, educating them, connecting them with other survivors to make that personal connection. And it's nothing like someone talking to someone that's just came off the highway that they're about to drive on. That's something that's missing in society today, that personal connection. That personal support helps your mental, physical, emotional health, financial health. Cancer today seems to have an epidemic outbreak that impacts our world today at a very high alarming rate. Although medical research has improved the life expectancy, you know, people are living longer. I do believe further research needs to be done on our environment, such as the food we consume, the consumption of medication, and how we interact with electronic devices, and how it impacts the human body, such as our circulatory, digestive, endocrine, and our muscular system. I do believe that further research needs to be studied on the cause before we can find a cure for all the cancers. And also, as long as people are fighting cancer, the Pink Queen Foundation will be around to make that personal connection with cancer survivors that need our services and support. We're here.